one of the great things about this is putting words into the mouth of a character who's very well formed. We all know who Harry Potter is. Yeah. Did you at any point think kids are not going to accept this?
No, not really. The bits that concerned me were where we could take Harry. I think I was frightened of people being upset by that version of Harry. And John was like, you got our Harry right. John saying that to me was hugely important for how I then tackled the rest of it.
Today I have the pleasure of speaking to Jack Thorne, who's the author of the play Harry Potter and the Cursed Child, now showing at Melbourne's Princess Theatre. Jack, welcome.
Thank you for having me.
I want to hear about the origins of your involvement with this project. When it was first told to you, hey, we're going to make a play, how close to the beginning was that?
I was walking down the street with John Tiffany, and John said to me, they've offered me the Harry Potter play. I never considered what would be the next sentence, which is, do you fancy having a go at it? I fell off the pavement. I was genuinely very, very shocked.
What made you say yes?
I think everyone else sort of wrestled with it, but for me, there was no wrestling. I was ridiculously stupid and just kind of dived in straight away and went, of course, that would be amazing. And then I thought about it and went, oh, wow.
Were you a Harry Potter fan? Did you know?
Yes.
A lot? Oh, were you?
I'm, you know, the total, yeah, Potterhead.
So you'd read the books, you'd seen the movies.
Yes.
Now the idea of a play was presented. Did you see any inherent danger in adapting this enormous popular figure for the stage?
Not at that moment. And then subsequently, the danger sort of screamed at me every day for 2 years.
Oh, no, don't tell me.
But, you know, the horror of, like, letting down that world became much more apparent. The reason why I sort of blithely walked into it was, A, it was a book I loved, and I always think things you love, you'll always find a way through it. And B, John asked me, and I trust him implicitly.
Jo, as you call her, we all know her as J.K. Rowling.
Yes.
What was she like when you very first met her?
She was amazing. I think her son was just turned 10, and we were talking about how difficult 10 was, and it just sort of rolled from there. It was just Jo, and she was amazing right from the beginning. And that first day we spent together, the three of us, in that writing room was, you know, yeah, will always remain one of the most thrilling of my life.
You agreed to do the play, you talked
Yes.
to Jo Rowling, you had meetings, you were working with John Tiffany, who you trusted and liked.
Yes.
And the decision was to tell it in two parts. Whose decision was it to make it? It
came from Colin and Sonia, and they said, we're not sure we're going to be able to do this in one part. And honestly, it hadn't occurred to me. But the truth is that if we did that version, we'd always be in a rush. We'd always be powering through, getting through plot, then this happens, then this happens, and there'd be no time for the sort of delving into the psychology of these characters.
Exactly.
So it is one play. It's one play told over two parts, because that was the only way of making it work.
So was that liberating for you?
No, because I had to write even faster.
Are you a playwright or a writer who responds to pressure like that in a positive way?
Yeah, I do like a deadline. I do like being told when something is due. If I have to survive on 3 hours sleep for a week, then, do you know what I mean? Like, you know, there's part of me that quite enjoys the challenge of that.
The first night you saw this play
Yes.
in London.
Yes.
What was it like?
It was interesting because it was with, you know, not much of an audience. And then the next time we did it, there was slightly more audiences. And then the first preview, suddenly it was a rock concert. The fear left me that night. And I think everyone that was there that night, it was an experience unlike any other.
Jack, thank you very much for talking today. It's been terrific to talk to you.
It's been really fun. Thank you very much.